In this way, when we go on our Beaujolais excursion this afternoon, we don't have to climb up and over. As you can see, Viking is already on its way to Vienne, and we are backing into the perfect spot. This is a very small Beaujolais family business that dates back to the 13th century. It's always handed down. This portion was planted in 1895. You must use Gamay grapes for Beaujolais appellation.
So we're just going to go inside, so move a bit further. You will see what my great-great-grandfather built at the beginning of the 19th century. I'm just going to explain briefly how do we make the wine here in the Beaujolais region. We pick the grapes. After it has been picked, we keep it whole. We keep the whole bunch because you're on top of the vats. These are concrete vats. We work with concrete vats and they are open on top. So we pour the grapes in, and what happens is at the bottom of the vat, we're going to have juice naturally obtained from the weight of the grapes crushing the other ones. This juice is very, very important because we produce Gamay grapes. The problem is Gamay grapes has white juice, dark skin, and we want to make red wine. So of course, we have to keep the juice in contact with the skin as much as possible to extract the color, but also to extract the tannins. The yeasts here are naturally present, so they come from the grapes itself on top of the juice. And on top of the vat, and that's also another very specific thing from the Beaujolais wines, the yeasts that are naturally present on the grapes are going to be pushed inside each berry. And the fermentation process will happen within each individual berry. 4 to 5 days for a very light fruity wine, but it can last up to 15 days, for example, for a wine with more body. What we do during this period, I don't know if you can all see, but down here, we use this to pump the juice every single day, and we pour it on top of the vat. We do that once a day, twice a day, three times a day, depending on the temperature, depending on many factors. We need the juice to stay in contact with the skins as much as possible. It's fun when you do it once or twice, but then afterwards, not that fun. And then the remaining part that was floating on top is brought to the wine press, the yellow machine over there, to extract the remaining juice. Then we bring both juices together, the one naturally obtained and the one from the wine press. We put it back into a vat, another concrete vat that has been cleaned by myself. The juice back in the vat, and this time the malolactic fermentation happens. This is essentially the conversion of malic acid into lactic acid. It is a very important process because if you stopped here, your wine would be very acid. It would be difficult to drink. Finish that, your wine is stabilized. It is okay. And you can keep it for many years. That's not a problem. After this comes the maturing process, the aging process. This depends really on the type of wine that you want to have. We can leave it in concrete vats. You will be able to taste a wine that has stayed in a concrete vat for 5 months.
This is the best part of the day. It is freezing out here. It's like fall, winter Chicago weather, which is not good.
Soils are so varied that we get different wines just because of this. So you will taste it. It's the same grape variety because it's a Beaujolais wine, so it has to come from a Gamay grapes. It is very special because it comes from the 125-year-old plot. So this one, compared to what I just explained, is not called a Beaujolais because it does not follow exactly the process that I described at the over there. Beaujolais,
it's called a wine barrels.
And so this one is Chardonnay. the white ones, which are goat cheese. In the middle, you have the saucisson, which is essentially a dried sausage. It's from 2019. So it's a fairly young wine that can be kept for 3-4 years, no problem, and of course in good storage condition. It's very easy to drink, fruity, light, easy to drink. We drink it with everything, breakfast, and everything. Very happy to have you here.
Grandpa's generation number 6.
And it is called, we're allowed to call it...
The Beaujolais region is divided into 3 parts. There's Beaujolais, Beaujolais Village, and Grand Cru Beaujolais.
But you don't expose it to the...
This is a 2016 from the Julian area. It has
usually
an orange
with a red
hue when
wine,
it's old.
You start seeing orange hues is because of the old age.
Really?
So that's a 2016 for many years. So 2018 and you can keep it for 6 years, no problem.
And this one is named after Camille.
I like when we have time because you can taste 3 Gamay-based wine, but completely different.
They're all completely different. This was delicious, too. This is aged in concrete, then oak, and it's a 2018.